Have you ever wanted to see inside of someone's brain? Well, science has a few ways of reading your mind. Hi guys, Julia here for DNews. The brain is made up of more than 100 billion neurons, all connecting and firing, registering information from the senses, forming memories, and making you, well, you. But how do we know what's going on in there? Back in the day, it took something horrific, like an iron rod going through your skull, for scientists to know what a part of the brain did. An iron rod went through Phineas Gage's temporal lobe in the mid-1800s, which forever changed his personality, which led scientists to discover that the temporal lobe might have something to do with emotion. Phrenology was a big thing in the 1800s too. Since they really couldn't see into a brain without injuring or killing a person, scientists believed that the shape of your head related to certain traits. Like a protruding forehead might mean you're intelligent. Phrases like highbrow and lowbrow can trace their roots back to phrenology. But in the century since, we've become a little more advanced in the way we look at the brain. When we talk about the brain here on DNews, we frequently mention MRI, or magnetic resonance imaging technique. But what is it, and how the hell does it see into the brain? Well, the technique is sort of new. It's only been around for about 20 years or so. Like the name suggests, the machine is basically a giant tube-shaped magnet. Basically, as you lie there, the machine aligns the hydrogen atoms in your body. These aligned atoms give off very faint signals. The machine uses these signals to take images of your insides in slices, kind of like slicing a loaf of bread. To see inside the brain, the machine takes advantage of the differences in magnetic properties between oxygen-rich and oxygen-poor blood. Basically, when neurons fire, they need energy. They don't store it in themselves, so they need a quick hit of energy from blood. So this technique works on the idea that if you see an increase in blood flow to an area of the brain, there's increased activity there. So scientists can see what part of the brain is working during different tasks, like talking or seeing. However, it works too slowly to capture the changes in the brain that can happen in a millisecond. NIRS also measures blood flow. Near-infrared spectroscopy shoots a beam of light through the skull and measures how that light changes on the way out. The way it changes depends on how much blood there is in a certain part of the brain. But other techniques can measure electrical activity in the brain. EEG measures this through up to 256 electrodes placed on the scalp. It's an old technique. Some form of EEG has been around for over 80 years. As neurons fire, they give off electrical signals, which are picked up by the electrodes. This way, researchers can measure quick changes in the brain that can happen in the blink of an eye. While MRIs are used more often these days, EEGs are still used to diagnose conditions like epilepsy. MEG is a kind of mix of both. It detects the magnetic fields created by electrical firing in the brain. Basically, when the brain's neurons fire in a certain pattern, it creates small magnetic fields detected by squids. No, not actual squids. I mean a superconducting quantum interference device. But both of these measure activity on the surface of the brain. The best we have for deep brain imaging for now is the fMRI, or functional magnetic resonance imaging. And in the past 5 years, thousands of studies depend on this technique to discover things like where emotions are registered in the brain and diagnosing mental illnesses, which is so cool. As neuroscientist Richard Koyak puts it, fMRI has paved the way for turning psychology into a biological science. Who knows what the future of brain imaging will hold? All right, guys, have you ever had an MRI? I did once, and it was really, really weird. I didn't feel anything, but it was so loud. Tell us about your experience down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here to DNews. We've got new episodes every day of the week.